It was an 11th hour decision, but a federal judge has blocked the online posting of blueprints that allow people to make these 3D guns. But this legal fight is not over. And joining me now is Brian Claypool. He's a survivor of the Las Vegas massacre, and Jan Morgan, a Second Amendment advocate and a certified firearms instructor. Thanks to both of you for being here. Brian, look, the Las Vegas massacre was very recent. Obviously, there are still so many physical and emotional wounds from that. What did you think when you heard that it was possible to use your 3D printer and create an untraceable, unregistered gun?
Utter shock. I was in despair. I was grieving again. I was re-victimized and re-traumatized. I spoke to your colleague, Chris Cuomo, shortly after the shooting in Vegas, and I told him, I said, during that shooting, the first round of shots, pop, 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 I thought I was dead. Second round of shots, I said, if I survive, I'm going to fight and make sure this never happens again. Now, instead of just fighting to eliminate assault weapons, now I have to fight on behalf of people across the country, victims of gun violence, people who care about public safety. I now have to fight to stop a company from providing a blueprint to any lunatic on this planet to go out and kill people. It's a license to kill, and it's a recipe for mass carnage.
Jan, explain from your perspective how this makes sense. How does it make sense to allow people a homemade gun they can make in the privacy of their own home that is untraceable and that you can bring in, that passes through a metal detector into stadiums, onto planes, et cetera?
Okay, well, first of all, whether it makes sense or not and how we feel about it, and Brian, I'm sorry about what you have had to go through, truly I am, but feelings and whether or not it's fair is not the same thing as a right. Rights are different from government-issued privileges. And this is more than just a Second Amendment. This is a First Amendment right issue. This guy was going to publish the blueprints. And if we're going to start censoring any kind of information out there on the internet that might do irreparable harm, then we're going to have to take off all the websites that are out there that teach you how to make explosive devices and bombs, websites that are doing irreparable harm, such as pornography, websites that teach people how to poison other people. I mean, there's a wealth of information out there that is very dangerous on the internet. So this is a First Amendment issue. Yeah. On the issue of the firearms, we already, Allison and Brian, it is already against federal law to manufacture a firearm that is undetectable. But
sure,
where the confusion lies is whether or not it's traceable.
Yeah.
There are.
But listen,
I just want
to stop you for a second because you made a lot of points, Jan. Hold on one second. I mean, making it easier. Okay, so making it easier to have one of these guns. You say it's illegal, but the blueprints were online. 1,000 people downloaded them. So there you go.
Actually, it's not easier, Allison. It's not easier.
Making it easier to get
access
to the
blueprints. In fact, making... No.
1,000 people downloaded it. That's more than had it 2 weeks
ago. I could go to a hardware store and get the pieces, the parts that I need to make a shotgun. I could do that. You don't have to have. In fact, the printable, 3D printable firearms are much more complicated to make than just building your own. And it is not illegal in America to manufacture your own firearm out of metals in your home and not have it registered.
Okay. Let me get Brian in.
It's illegal to make one that's undetectable by metal detectors.
Got it. Brian, when you hear her talk about that this is a right, yeah, that this is a First Amendment right, what's your response?
That's the problem with our society. First of all, the First Amendment doesn't give you the right to break the law. The federal law currently says that you can't make plastic guns without serial numbers. So you're not protected by the First Amendment. That's the first thing. The second thing is, instead of President Trump calling the NRA, guess what? Give me a call and give victims across this country a phone call who have dodged bullets from assault weapons and find out how they feel about it before you propagate this recipe for mass disaster. Do you know that on their website they have what's called a VZ-58, Allison? Do you know what that is? It's a 17-inch long gun, 7 pounds. It's going to carry out mass killing.
That's what they're giving the blueprint to?
That's one of the blueprints. And do you know, on top of that these bullets that are in these weapons are made to destroy your body? When they enter your body, they destroy you. So this is not acceptable in a civilized society.
Yeah.
And it's not funny. That's not funny. You go.
No,
you
what
go,
is what
you
is funny?
Go, you
what
go
is funny, Brian?
Mass
no, can, let
you
me,
go
can
dodge
I answer
bullets.
No,
you go
what is
dodge
funny
bullets.
Is your
no, no. What's funny
let me
is
tell
you
who's
sit
dodged
behind
bullets.
Your cushy
thousands and thousands
chair.
Of United States veterans oh, have gone into the line of fire to defend liberty, to defend the Bill of Rights.
It
is
not about liberty.
It is a Bill of Rights, Brian. And our feelings do not. Your feelings are not relevant when it comes to rights.
But Jen, listen. Okay, so let's. So I hear what you're saying. You're saying that you don't want to deal with feelings for policy. Okay. How about the fact that we do have a mass shooting problem in this country? How will
not
this
policy
help mass
rights.
Shooting?
Here's the answer, Allison. If you really want, if Brian and the Democrats really want to address the issue
it's
of
not
mass
a Democratic
shooting,
issue.
They need to talk about the one thing that no one wants to talk about, which is the number of mass shootings that involve psychotropic drugs. Stephen Paddock, the very guy.
Yeah,
who
I know that that's where you guys always go, but I
want to
stay focused
from.
On the homemade guns.
Because it's
I know
the
that
truth.
You want to talk about the
Why
do, drugs.
It's not just us
but,
guys.
But
it's
let's,
not
okay.
just the NRA. It's
fine.
Not
Jen,
just
hold on. Let me pose my question
it
to you because it is connected to mental
Big
health.
Big Pharma does not want to discuss
Jen.
It. Big Pharma doesn't
Jen, how does
it
help to have somebody mentally ill be able to print
it.
Their own gun, make their own gun off a 3D printer at home?
Stephen Paddock obtained his firearm legally. This wasn't
I'm just
a
curious. This is just my question.
Gun.
Just answer this
criminals,
question.
No,
how does
criminals,
it help to be able to have a mentally ill person create their own gun at home?
Mentally ill people can create their own guns regardless of the law. Criminals and thugs
but how is
and
it
terrorists
better to make
don't
it
abide by the law. So no laws, Allison, I'm sorry that you can't get this, but no law is going to stop a criminal
yeah,
or a terrorist
I guess that we just don't believe that laws
from,
are completely ineffective.
Killing mass numbers of
I mean,
people.
I think that people just don't believe that
laws have not been effective.
Never stop anything.
Look at
I
Chicago.
Think that we do think that
Chicago
laws stop
has
crime.
More gun control laws. We already have over 20,000 gun control laws in America, Allison, and they don't address the problem. But
fair
how about
enough.
This?
So you
How
think that
this?
Laws don't
Paris,
matter.
France.
Gotcha.
Paris, France.
Fair
Can
enough.
I please speak? Paris, France is a gun-free utopia. How many people died in that mass shooting? Because terrorists and bad guys and crazy people will always have access to guns.
And
the
maybe they can
way
print
to
them
stop
now.
Mass shootings
in their own
to,
den.
The best way to stop.
Hold on, Jen.
The best way to stop mass shootings is to legally arm law-abiding citizens.
Got it. Your point. Your last point, Brian.
And my last point is you are bypassing background checks. You are bypassing mental health background checks. You are bypassing serial numbers on the guns, and this is going to allow any lunatic on the planet to go in his or her own home and make a gun and carry out another mass shooting. And if this happens again, Jan, you know what? You're going to have blood on your hands, and this government's going to have blood on its hands.
All right, guys, on that note, I know it's very heated. I know that there's a lot of feelings, understandably, on both sides. Jan, Brian, thank you very much for the debate. We'll see where this goes.
Thank you.